Yeah, perfectly right. I got my C6015 IPCs here, one of our technology highlights of the last years. And they all look the same, but the inside is different. And that's what I would like to talk about right now, because they are in use in the field of operating systems. And that's why I invited two experts, because I got Heiko and Daniel with me. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
And the topic is operating system. Seems to be boring, but it is not, because there's something going on at this trade show for the first time.
Yeah.
Traditionally, we always promote Windows as the backbone operating system. Since a couple of years, we have TwinCAT BSD as a second pillar, but now we announce Linux as an operating system in the Beckhoff world. So what is this all about, Heiko?
Yeah, so as you already mentioned, since 2019, we have already TwinCAT BSD as a second operating system as an alternative to Windows. And since then, it's already serving as a robust and stable platform for TwinCAT, and also is used by a lot of customers for a stable machine controller. But nevertheless, there are also a lot of customers asking for Linux environment, because they already have Linux software they want to run. They want to make use of some special Linux technologies, for example, containerization. And therefore, we also now decided to offer a Linux distribution with our PCs. Yeah, so, and the Beckhoff Linux distribution is based, it's not completely by our own, so it's based on the very popular and well-known Debian distribution, which is it's a community distribution, well-known, also used by a lot of other distributions all over the world. And this is our stable base now, and this is now hosted by us. That means we are offering that together with our IPCs. You can order it in the future also together with our IPCs, and the customer gets a Linux operating system on the PC, which is tested with Beckhoff PC. Yeah, and then he has a stable platform also for Linux software.
Okay, but that means in this case that when we talk about the Linux distribution, it's part of our PC business. So we have a PC with Microsoft, a PC with BSD, now a PC with Linux. But where is the value for the customer? Because our customers would like to put TwinCAT on the system most of the time. So is this possible as well?
Yes, of course. So I think it's important to note that the TwinCAT runtime is the same on Linux as for Windows and TwinCAT BSD. So for our customers, this means the engineering stays the same and the functionality also stays the same. So they can interact with the Linux based IPCs in the same way from a TwinCAT point of view as they do with TwinCAT BSD and Windows. But also everything, first of all, stays the same.
Yeah.
There's also new possibilities. Heiko already mentioned the containerization technology. Mm-hmm. Now it's also possible to host TwinCAT runtime inside containers. And this is also the first time with containers that we can host multiple TwinCAT runtimes on one IPC.
So in case you have maybe a long machine line with different modules, you can still separate this now on one IPC, so you get multiple runtimes on the same IPC.
Exactly, yes. So this is different as before. Before you could already write modular TwinCAT software, but you always had one runtime. Now that you have multiple runtimes on one IPC, you can use these runtimes to program and execute and also exchange them individually on one IPC. And therefore you could, for example, control one machine segment with runtime in container A and the second machine segment with the runtime in container B independently from each other.
Now, but if I want to get access to all these new features and functions on Linux, I think people always were concerned in the past because it's a GPU, a general public license, the Linux itself.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that even ourselves, we mentioned many years now that this is a bit dangerous because then customers might have to open also their code. Mm-hmm. Same for us. Mm-hmm. Now, is this obstacle gone now, or what's the situation?
Yes, we are using a different approach here with the Linux runtime, because we are not running in kernel mode like on TwinCAT BSD. We are running in user mode. That means on top of the GPL license kernel, and there on top you can have proprietary software. There is also other proprietary software available on Linux, and we are doing now the same. And this is possible because now we are using the so-called real-time patch for Linux. It's an addition to the Linux kernel, which will be integrated probably already this year completely. So then it's coming out of the box more or less. And this is what we are using then below to make the runtime real-time capable on Linux as well. And therefore, we are free from the GPL obligations.
Okay, so it's like an application program more or less, or how can I see this?
Yeah, exactly. It's like an ordinary user space application customers may know from, like, compared on Windows, like Word or Outlook or whatever. So we are just running in user space. It's also the reason why we can containerize TwinCAT itself. So yeah, as Heiko said, we have no part inside the Linux kernel. We take the off-the-shelf real-time patch. Yeah.
So we have a small footprinted Linux operating system now, good performance, new features, independent. I think it's expensive. Is this free? What is the pricing model for that?
No, we have decided to use the same pricing model as we already use for TwinCAT BSD. That means the license price, it's a one-time fee. So customers pay one time, and then they get updates until the end of the controller life. That's the general approach. And the license fee depends on the performance level on the CPU. So we have the TwinCAT 3 performance level already for the TwinCAT license. And we are using the same performance level also for the license of the operating system. So small controller, smaller license, bigger controller, a little bit higher license. Yeah.
So we open our scalability, which we have in hardware, also in software. So it's Microsoft, it's TwinCAT BSD, or it's Linux. Mm-hmm. It can be small devices, bigger devices, all is possible. Key question is, what do I do with my TwinCAT now? So I have to reprogram everything, or I just drop it to my new Linux?
No, you just more or less drop it, because as I said, the engineering says the same. You just choose the different TwinCAT target system. Now it's Linux-based, but it doesn't matter from a TwinCAT point of view. You select the target system is Linux-based, you activate your configuration, and then you're more or less fine.
Right, perfect. I know, Heiko, you will start with the first embedded controllers this summer already, using the Linux distribution, and we start with other IPCs later this year. Excellent news, gentlemen. I hope to get a lot of questions this trade show, and we move on. Thank you so far.
Thank you.